Although the U.S. has called for a ceasefire in Yemen and for all parties to come to the negotiating table, over the past 12 days, Saudi-backed militants increased their attacks on the impoverished country and suffered great losses in the face of strong retaliatory operations and resistance by Ansar Allah movement fighters.
The retaliatory operations have cut off all the supply lines of enemy forces. They have inflicted heavy losses on invading forces and caused chaos among them. Enemy fighter jets have not been able to back militants on the ground. Thus, they have been forced to evacuate injured personnel by helicopters, leaving behind dozens of dead bodies.
Despite their failure to protect their supply lines, Saudi-backed forces have been able to get closer to the coastal city of Al-Hudaydah to heavily bombard densely areas in the outskirts of the city. Civilians who have fled the fierce battles told Press TV about their problems.
I've just fled the port city of Hudaydah along with my family to Sana'a due to the fierce battles that are taking place there. The humanitarian situation there is really catastrophic. Here, there is no humanitarian organizations to receive displaced people, so we fled death to face another uncertainty.
Meanwhile, the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees expressed concern over the dire humanitarian situation of civilians who are trapped inside the port city.
Fierce clashes, airstrikes and shelling have inflicted scores of civilian casualties. There is also damage to civilian infrastructure, including health facilities and houses. UNHCR is worried that people needing to flee for safety are unable to do so. We are especially concerned that the fighting is blocking access to our humanitarian supplies in Hudaydah.
As testament to how dire the situation is, some 445,000 people from Al-Hudaydah have been forced to flee since June.
Saudi-backed militiamen have launched a vast offensive to take full control of Yemen's strategic western coastal city of Al-Hudaydah as Riyadh's regime presses ahead with its atrocious bombardment campaign against its southern neighbor. This comes as Yemen's Ansar Allah says the U.S. is the main culprit behind the aggressor's atrocities in Yemen, stating that Washington is making use of policies of deception and extortion. Hamad Attab, Press TV, Sana'a.